the folks that Dano has up in the booth. I just love their music. Dano, yeah, take it away.
I think a lot of us in the New York area love their music an awful lot. I'm very happy to say we have Jules Holland, Glenn Tilbrook here from Squeeze sitting in our booth. Guys, welcome. It's like, actually, we were here just a couple of months ago.
We did some nights at the Ritz, mad party nights. And I must say that coming back to New York is always our favourite place to come back to, isn't it, Glenn?
That's absolutely right, Julian.
It really is. It's our second home. I don't think there's any need for derisory laughter, thank you very much.
It's not derisory.
Have you painted the scene here?
No, Jules, please take over and go ahead.
Well, it's quite fantastic. We're here at this vast stadium. It's a cavernous place, and there are sort of, I suppose, 2,000 or 3,000 people milled in. Bit of a shame they haven't built the roof yet, and it is raining, so they're getting a little bit wet. And over at the end of the stadium, there is a huge spider with 8 legs, a vast spider, which later David will be coming out on, and we're going to be performing underneath the huge spider.
I see. Is the spider also act as an umbrella for you on stage?
Yes, it does, and it'll sort of be putting a web over us, and we'll be throwing a bit of fly spray out on it.
It's a bit of a multi-purpose spider, really.
If that web comes off over or something like that, isn't that how the spider lures its prey into the web, and you get stuck there? And aren't you concerned about it?
I believe so, and the implication is, of course, that we're just a load of flies.
You guys, what I was trying to say before, you were at the Ritz, all right? Now, is that the reason why you went to the Ritz, is that because you had some new material and you wanted to try out some new material, or just need a quick supply of cash, or what was it?
It was a bit of everything, really. We certainly needed a quick supply of cash.
Always
in need of cash.
Yeah.
Any donations gratefully received.
Where do we send them, buddy?
Just send them right here now.
Oh.
Don't delay. Get over to the Giant Stadium, go up to the radio booth, and give us your money.
All right.
Now, I just wanted to say, guys, a real burning question that's been bothering me is, how do you like the chicken we have in the booth here?
It's quite fantastic. I believe it's the same chicken that David made it himself personally earlier in his special cooking facility room that he has here. It really is a very impressive show. I mean, for those of you that can't get out here, I mean, when that spider lights up and he comes out and I believe he'll be eating chicken on stage. It's one of the things he does. They get particularly frenzied at that point. He sits down, has a bit of chicken, and they go wild. I tried it on our first night with David, just eating a bit of chicken on stage, but nobody seemed to notice.
Didn't have the same energy.
No. I'm not such a performer as he, you see.
Yeah, I guess he makes those broad, expansive movements of eating chicken.
Yes.
And it comes across a lot better. Well, I want to talk about your music. You got some new music coming.
Yep, we have.
On a lighter note.
Yes. Glenn, tell them about this. We're very pleased with our new record, actually.
Yes, we've been locked away for about the past 6 months doing an album. It's almost getting to be like Pink Floyd, this band, the amount of time we spend making a record. And the surprising thing is that we actually did most of it live, so I don't know how we managed to spend 6 months doing it. But we've got a single out, The Hourglass. It's not actually out yet. It comes out in a couple of weeks. And that's fairly indicative of the way that the album has turned out, because we did it live.
The album is called Babylon and On. Any special significance behind that? Or is it just you, Jules, or what?
Yes, there's no stopping me, is there, really?
Well, we like that. That's okay. Go ahead.
The chicken's very nice. Another thing, David doesn't do it on this tour, unfortunately, and he is really very fantastic to watch. I must say that. He is really quite an extraordinary man to watch. But he used to, years ago, in his live shows, he would do mime. You know, he would pretend there was a wall there, and I don't know if you've ever seen that, but that was a thing he would do. And if I may, I'd like to do a little bit of mime for the people at home.
Oh, I think they couldn't wait for this.
Okay, here's me being a wall on fire.
Wow.
Yeah,
that
pretty good,
is very
stunning.
Impressive.
I don't think you had that on the wireless.
You look just like a wall on fire.
Before.
Oh, my God. I hope everyone at the radio audience appreciated that.
Yeah.
It was brilliant. So why don't we take a listen to Hourglass? Anything specific to say about this song?
We have done a video for it, which hopefully will be shown quite soon. And it is a worthwhile video looking out for, because it is a surrealist video where everything goes out of proportion. Other than that, no, the record speaks for itself.
All right, let's listen to it speak right now. This is New Squeeze at 102.7 WNAW-FM. It's called Hourglass. Oh, yes, that is feedback live from Giant Stadium at 102.7 WNAW-FM. That is Hourglass. It is brand new from Squeeze. Now, don't run out to the record shops just yet, because it won't be available for at least a couple of weeks here in the States. That is an import copy of it right now, and we want you to save your money and be ready to buy that.
Right.
When it comes out, right?
Right.
Right, we are live at Giant Stadium.
Very big place, isn't it? No wonder it's called. They must be very big, the people that come here.
Yeah, the Giants that come here to Giant Stadium. So, I just wanted, you are hooking up, you hooked up with the entire Bowie tour here in the States. Was it the same in Europe as well? Did you play? Or no?
No, we're not really doing the entire tour at all. In fact, we've just done two nights at Philadelphia, which we finished the night before last. We're doing these two nights, and then we're going back home again on Tuesday.
I see. And what is the plans for Squeeze? What do you have the grand master plan worked out yet, or is it just going to be on a wing?
Yes. Well, we are planning to tour quite extensively, and it'll be quite a change for us to include Britain in those plans as well. We're going to do a 5-week tour over there, and then we'll come back here in November for a month or 5 weeks, and then again in January. Mm,
5 weeks here at the Giant Stadium, and then all of January here at the Giant Stadium. We'll be shipping people in from different parts of the United States to see us.
I love Squeeze for always innovating, you know.
Yes, it's a first.
Usually the band comes to people, but this time I think it's important for the band to come, or the people to come to the band.
People will be coming with their tents and things.
Should they bring chicken?
They should bring their own chicken. We noticed that Prince, when he played in England, he had a party at Marquee Club, and as well as having to have a special pass to get into the party, at the party, he himself had a special tent that was inside the marquee where you needed a gold card to get in. So Squeeze are now having our own personal bivouacs and tents each. And we'd like, and you notice out here tonight, you can see the odd tent put up, and that must mean that there is a huge celebrity in that tent.
Well, huge celebrity,
just to point this out, Jules, over on the side, there is a little tiny tent. Is that the Jules Holland tent?
I think that's Paul McCartney there. Oh. Yes, I can just see Linda popping out there.
Oh. There's a little horse. Hi there. Yeah. Nice. Mm-hmm.
People are filing into Giant Stadium, and it's getting more and more filled up, and that's good news tonight. Does the rain bother you at all?
No. You know, we were reading yesterday an article by Phil Spector's wife.
Ronnie?
Yes, Ronnie. Mm-hmm. And she's, I think this is so true of Glenn and I in many ways, and she said that when she plays to a stadium, she feels as she only feels happy as if she's felt as though she's made love to everybody in that stadium.
So if people are driving in now,
that's right, from all over America,
they should take notice of this.
And proper precautions.
All right. I'm not going to be able to hold this together for the broadcast.
Sure you are. Come on.
It's always great to have Squeeze by here at WNAWFM. We heard some music exclusively from Babble On and On, and I think we have another song here. Would you guys care to set this up for us?
Yes, this is my stab at doing a sort of odd track, which didn't actually make it onto the album. It will, however, be on the compact disc and the cassette versions.
I see. So people should go and buy those as well as the album.
Hello? David? Is that David?
Do you know John? No, that's not David. Oh. He's not at No Chicken with him.
No.
This is John Schur.
Right.
He's the concert promoter, and he's the guy that if you don't get the right amount of money at the end of the show, you talk to him.
Yes, he's wearing shorts, isn't he?
Yeah. So count your cash, guys.
Rather smart shorts, yes, indeed. John is, I think, beginning to make some stage announcements just to try and keep people safe so that, as you notice, it's general admission on the field here.
Yeah.
And they're trying to be sure that they don't crush forward and therefore make a really nasty
scene.
It's
terrifying, isn't it?
Yes. So what I'd like to do, though, is play this song. You were saying you were creating an unusual song.
Yes, it's quite an unusual song. For those of you who are interested in chord changes, you'll notice a particularly odd chord change at around about the spot that we musicians call the middle eight. The middle eight.
I think as well, the other thing you could say is it's probably the only time it'll be played on the radio, I expect, isn't it?
Well, for
so
the only
first and a last for us,
right, for the very first and last time.
Brilliant song.
We are live at Giant Stadium with Jules Holland and Glenn Tolbrook of Squeeze. This is their new record at 102.7 WNAW-FM in New York. It is an exclusive. It is killer.
That is new from Squeeze at 102.7 WNAW-FM. And let's go back to Giant Stadium with the Squeeze interview with Dano. Hello,
yeah,
Dano.
This is the Squeeze interview.
That's right. We bill it as that.
Yeah, okay.
Just as well. It is us here.
Yes, it is Jules Holland and Glenn Tolbrook sitting here with me at Giant Stadium. They're going to go on second in the bill here. The show is going to open up with Lisa and Colt Jam.
Second?
Yeah, you didn't know that.
Oh.
I thought we were topping the bill.
Oh, well, yeah, in many people's minds you are, but then in others, no.
Largely those five or six people on stage when we're playing.
How much?
Go ahead, Dano, run with
I'm
it.
I'm lost. Forget it. Has the band been playing a lot together? Have you been doing many rehearsals? I mean, you were one of the few bands that I know of that is well known that broke up and got back together again.
That's right. Well, this year, what we've been doing, we had a lot of time off last year to do some writing and rehearsing because of the way we did the album, as I said, was to try and record it as live as possible. So we wanted to have all the arrangements worked out and right before we went in the studio. So what we're doing now is to try and gig as much as possible, as often as possible. And if we have any periods of time when we're not gigging, say for instance in the next month, we're going to be doing the odd gig like every week or so, just to keep our hand in.
You know? You couldn't pick up any bigger gigs. I mean, you know, were you looking for bigger ones than these or whatever?
No, these will do all right for the time being, I think.
They're okay, yes. So how did it feel when you guys got back together to put together Cosi Fan Tutti Frutti? I mean, was it kind of like strange bedfellows getting back together, or was it like old times, or did you miss each other? What you know?
Well, when we first got back together, it was, I think, the last thing in my mind, up until we played this small pub gig, which is what resulted in us getting back together, the last thing on my mind was the band reforming at all, because I always thought, well, that's it, it's run its course, and we didn't have anything else to do. But then when we played again, it was obvious to me and to everyone in the band that, you know, we thought we had a lot more we could do, and that the time that we had off was much needed, and the band had generally improved so much in that time. It was a real pleasure to play again.
Well, I've
never been in bed with any of them.
what was the small pub gig that started it? I mean,
well, it was a pub that held, I suppose, about 100 people, and I booked this gig for myself to do it, and I was looking around for a band to do it, just for a one-off. So I thought, you know, let's go for an easy option. Some guys I know, we know a few songs. Let's do this gig together and see. Just for the fun of it, you know, and it certainly wasn't a large gig by any stretch of the imagination, but it went down really well, and it was such fun to, you know, go through all the old songs again.
Some of the memorable dates for me were back in the days when you guys were doing the Bottom Line here in New York, and even some other different clubs around here. I think you did CBGB's once.
Yeah.
I mean, those were such party gigs. I mean, it was always a lot of fun to see Squeeze in a small venue. Is that the kind of feeling you guys can create in a stadium like this? Can you do that? Can you get, I mean, you don't do Bang Bang anymore.
No.
You can't get the stadium to respond.
But it's interesting, you think, because it's much, I think we're very comfortable in the intimate atmosphere of a club or a theatre or something. But in a stadium, it also depends how much the crowd are on your side. I mean, this isn't really our gig, this is David Barry's gig, but Glenn will do things at the end of the gig to get everybody chanting and jumping up and down, and when they join in, and he sometimes does gets the whole crowd to do very complicated harmonies with one another, which change every night. And so
does this involve hypnotism at all?
No, animal magic, I can tell.
Yes, the spider starts to join in even at one point, I think. And so you can get a bit of a party atmosphere, and I think that's, you see, I think half the thing with a gig of this size, unlike when you're going to a small club, you're having a bit of a sort of a party, people come to a thing like this and they want a real event, you know.
Absolutely.
Have some of David's chicken, chant along with Squeeze, gone home happy, you know.
Well, we are very happy that you guys could come by, and I thank you very much for coming up to the broadcast booth here.
Thank you. Always happy to come on.
A pleasure.
Well, always remember, you have friends at WNDWFM. We always want you to stop by when you're in town. And please, when you come back on tour, stop up, okay?
We will.
This was recorded, and it will be played back every hour when you're in town.
Call up your room.
We want to leave you with a song from Cosi Fan Tutti Frutti. Do you want to sit up by your side?
Yep, here it is, by your side.
What more could you ask for? All right, Jules Holland, Glenn Tilbrook of Squeeze, thanks very much. And now this is By Your Side at 102.7 WNAW-FM.
Sky, a hair. Sorry about the English weather. This is a song out for our new album, which is going to be out soon. The album's called Babylon and On. This song's called Footprints.
Time looks far too bad. it out? Are you wet enough yet? Sorry about the rain. We tried to arrange better weather, but we didn't manage to get through to God on time. It's another new one. It's what traditionally people in concerts say. We're going to take things down a little bit. It's to this sort of song. It's called The Waiting Game. I'm
You've made my bed the finger points. Now is that the boy, boy, cool down? The easy love is found. Now that is the.
to him. Ladies and gentlemen, Keith Wilkinson.
Now, this is what it is, and this is what it's called. It's the hourglass.
Feel like I'm running up the steep hill. No one can see. Everyone's in the house, everyone's out. All the lights are on and the blinds are down. Thank you.
was thinking to myself, what can we do to try and help make that situation better for you?
Get up!
I was thinking to myself during the set, and I came up with an idea.
Get up!
The best thing that you can do in this sort of confined situation is to try and create a movement of air, therefore helping to dry everyone's clothes so you can go on and enjoy David's show. The way that I thought we might do this, and again, only if you want to, I'm not going to try to force or badger anyone into doing anything that they've got to do, but I would like to call out random numbers, at which point you will jump up in the air, that same amount of numbers, while we play those same sort of 1, 2, 3 splashes that we were doing just then. Are you ready? I said, are you ready?